the show tonight, a power-packed panel. Seshadri Chari, member of the BJP, Vinod Sharma, political editor of the Hindustan Times, Vidya Subramaniam, deputy editor of the Hindu, and Ashok Malik, news columnist, and someone who is also a senior journalist. Before we get into our discussion with this packed and powerful panel, the top story on Face the Nation. Should L.K. Advani have resigned earlier this year when the BJP crushingly lost the general elections in which he was the prime ministerial candidate? Many now feel he should have. Here's a report from Shreya Sardesai.
From being the man responsible for the rise of the BJP in the 1990s to being blamed for its fall in 2009, L.K. Advani's fortunes have suffered a sharp fall. And the past 3 months have been particularly harsh for the BJP's Iron Man. On May 16th, when the BJP crashed to a crushing defeat in the Lok Sabha elections, it was clear to most that the mandate of the people had meant a rejection of BJP's 81-year-old prime ministerial aspirant. But Advani, it seems, failed to read the writing on the wall and held on to his leader of the opposition status. His refusal to own up for the party's defeat angered his detractors, who accused the party of putting a premium on failure. Then came the Jinnah controversy and the unceremonial sacking of Jaswant Singh for praising Jinnah in his book. It was expected that Advani, who had also praised Jinnah in 2005, would come to Jaswant's rescue, but that did not happen. In order to save his own position within the party, the BJP's Mazboot Neta turned his back on his colleague for 30 years.
Lalji Advani had been to Karachi and had said something. I had even then stood up against what was being the treatment that was meted out to Lalji Advani.
Advani's credibility was further dented when his present and former colleagues openly declared that he had misled the public on the Kandahar hijacking episode.
It made sense to release these three and get the hostages back.
So the Home Minister of the day, L.K. Advani, was part and parcel of the decision?
Yes, of course.
Still struggling to wash off the Babri taint, the Kandahar revelations have come as a huge blow for Advani. But the biggest blow to his ambitions has perhaps come from the RSS, whose chief Mohan Bhagwat wants the BJP to go in for a generational change. The intervention by RSS has meant that time is clearly running out for L.K. Advani. He started the year on a high as BJP's prime ministerial candidate. He's all set to end it on a low by making a forced exit. In New Delhi, Shreya Sardesai.
So the initial results now of our SMS poll. Is it time for L.K. Advani to retire from public life? This is a very controversial question. It's a very bold question. Some would say, what are you telling us on our opinion poll? 85%, it's a huge majority, saying yes, it is time for L.K. Advani to go. Let's get into Crossfire. Seshadri Chari of the BJP, you're smiling. Now, the thing is, earlier this year, when the BJP crushingly lost the general elections, it was a bad defeat. It was a political defeat. And it was an election in which L.K. Advani was the prime ministerial candidate. Therefore, he had primary responsibility for that defeat. He went to the gym, he pumped iron, he reached out to the youth. The youth did not gravitate towards him. The people of India did not gravitate towards him. Why didn't he resign then, as his instinct told him to do?
Two things. Number one, although he was projected as the prime ministerial candidate, the election defeat was not singularly because of the fact that Mr. So-and-so was projected as the prime ministerial candidate. There were a number of reasons, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If the election defeat is because of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
His instinct at the time was to resign.
No, his instinct was there. He took the moral responsibility. He did resign. It was the party colleagues who felt that this should not have happened. So they prevailed upon him not to resign.
No, the thing is that it wasn't as if there was a band outside saying Advani, Aage Bado, etc., etc. Maybe one or two people might have asked him to stay on.
No, not one or two. The entire set of colleagues.
That's not the impression one gets.
No, it's not one
and
or two.
No, but even then, look at Sonia Gandhi. I mean, look at what happened.
No, there is no comparison between somebody from the Gandhi
Sharma,
family
the power of renunciation.
And the man who has
the political power of renunciation.
No. Well, of course, the power of renunciation, the power of austerity, the power of leading a very Spartan life. It is not just Sonia Gandhi, it was Mahatma Gandhi who gave this to this country. And anything that is ostentatious, that is clinging on to power, is not liked. But I will disagree with you with the suggestion, the proposition that Mr. Advani should retire from public life. John McCain hasn't retired from public life. Neither has Bill Clinton, who recently pulled off a big victory for the American diplomacy by getting those two journalists released from North Korea. Mm-hmm. My problem with Mr. Advani actually is that he continues to be leader of opposition. And he continues to be leader of opposition, perhaps in search of an opportunity to anoint people of his choice to crucial positions.
So he should not have a line function, but he should be in the public sphere.
Well, of course, I think
he should not have a line function.
No, he should not have a line function, but he should be there to provide guidance to his party. Because
but
he's got a wealth of experience.
That's
not the point. That's not what he's asking for.
No, no, no. The point
he
is, no, no. I'm not saying he has not said anything.
No.
He has neither said that he wants to be chairman of NDA, neither has he said he wants to.
No,
he said that I want to continue as leader of opposition.
5 years.
But that is where he can be faulted. That you want to continue as leader of opposition on what authority? You've been rejected by the people.
Okay.
Let your party present a new face, a leader of opposition, and you be in some other position.
But isn't it humiliating? Isn't it humiliating in the manner in which he has been attacked over these last couple of weeks? I mean, just one thing.